This is NDTV. And you're watching Classics.
Hello and welcome to Born Wild, the show that takes you to the heart of wild India. It takes you up close and personal to some of India's most endangered animals and the people who help them fight for their survival. In today's episode, we're going to talk about something that's unique, if not intrinsic, to India and very few other countries in the world. The thing in India is wildlife is never isolated from the influence of man. No matter where you go, even in the protected areas, wildlife coexists with people. Now, in some areas, this leads to tremendous conflict. But today, we're not going to look at those areas where this has led to conflict. We're going to look at areas where people have managed to coexist peacefully with the wildlife around them. We're going to meet some people who tolerate the wildlife around them, don't disturb them, and thereby enable them to get on with their own lives. And we're also going to meet some people who will lay their lives down before they will let any harm come to an animal.
Every year, the golden dunes on the edge of the Thar Desert at Kichen near Jodhpur take on a distinctly grey hue when thousands of demoiselle cranes fly down from Central Asia and China to winter here. As Gargi and I climbed up the slope near the lake that lies across the entire length of Kichen, it seemed that every dune was feathered and the sky filled with winging and wheeling birds. The demoiselle crane is the world's smallest crane, and it is the second most abundant crane in the world. The Kazakhstan, Central Asia, Eastern Asia populations are abundant and seen at low risk, while the North Africa populations and the Turkey populations, which are a subspecies, are seen as critically endangered. The birds that wing their way towards India come from the more abundant populations. Interestingly enough, records show that India was not really on their traditional route of winter migration. Even about 100 years ago, no more than a few hundred birds would fly across Jodhpur or land here in the sand. But a family in Kichen started to feed the birds grain. Soon this became a tradition, with most members of the Jain community here in this village feeding the birds. And in the last 100 years, from a few hundred birds, Kichen is now home to over 7,000 birds in the winter season.
This phenomenal sight that you can see above and beyond me is the arrival of the demoiselle cranes to the place where they're fed in Kichen. The demoiselle cranes are the second most abundant cranes in the world. Actually, they have a very, very healthy population. In fact, for once, as someone who's been covering wildlife for a while, it's a really positive sight to see an animal that one has come to film in such abundant numbers. We have seen with our naked eye close to at least 6,000 birds in this area. And the most amazing part of it is that in Kichen, this is not original crane land. This is on the edge of the Thar Desert. But with a little amount of water bodies scattered around this area, which get filled by the monsoons, these birds do come here for the winter. Initially, only about 100, 150 birds used to come, and that was about 40, 50 years ago. But since the community has become actively involved in feeding the birds, in not disturbing them, in making sure that the habitat that they come to is left undisturbed, thousands of birds have started coming. It's one of the most positive signs in conservation.
Unlike in many other countries where they're hunted indiscriminately and killed for any damage they cause to crops, here in Kichen, they're protected and the community sees them as a good luck charm. The few crop fields here in the village do not begrudge the birds a few seeds. The feeding area is in one corner of the village near the dunes. Grain is sprinkled on the ground every day. And as we stood there waiting, suddenly the sky above us filled with the calls of the demoiselle and nearly every inch around us was covered with flying birds. And this feeding is done every day for the entire season that the birds come to Kichen.
कम से कम कुदा यहाँ आने को 40 साल हो गए. बहुत कमाते थे, कमाते आते 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 तो बहुत बढ़ गए. हद से ज़्यादा, हमेशा ज़्यादा ही बढ़ती, फिर कम नहीं होती.
बढ़ते रहते हैं.
हाँ,
क्यों ऐसे क्यों हुआ?
हाँ, इनका यहाँ एक तो पानी की सुविधा, दूसरे चूगा इनको अच्छी तरह से मिलता है. और गोरा लोग बहुत आते देखने के लिए. रईस बईस भी बहुत आते, नाडी भरी हुई रहती है हमेशा, गाड़ियाँ मोटर से हरदम इनका होता ही रहता है. फोटो निकालते, कोई उठते देखते, कोई बैठते देखते, कोई जाते देखते, कोई पानी पीते देखते, सब तरह से देखते. तो नाडी के ऊपर गांव वाले भी लोग बहुत आते, तो बाहर से भी बहुत लोग आते कुर्दा देखने के लिए. तो कुर्दा के लिए यानी खींचन महसूस हो चुका है. कुर्दा बहुत अच्छी अच्छे पक्षी, दिखने में भी खूबसूरत.
The cranes have now become entwined with Rajasthani culture. The ability to fly such long distances, inspirational in the folk songs. The Khurjan, the traditional folk song, tells the story of a young princess waiting for her husband to come home. He's left for a distant land to make a fortune, and she misses him. She asks cranes flying overhead to take a message to him to tell him to come home to her. Most families have left Keechan and moved away. It's essentially a ghost town with very few people left. The Jain community has created a trust which ensures that the food grains are collected and the birds are fed. But every year it's getting tougher to organize with less and less people interested in the old traditions and the ways.